Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God didn't ask us for an alternate plan.
Amen.
God did not say, if you don't want to do it my way, just get your way and do it.
Come on.
So, for those that say, though, that he's only concerned with the money, somewhere they can say it's so good to make them convince folk to send the money and not come themselves.
Yeah.
But God wants you.
Yeah.
He don't just want you, but he want all of you.
Yeah.
And I learned when the army, and they used to say, Uncle Sam wants you.
Yeah.
And that's what they meant. Amen. He didn't want part of you. He wanted you. Praise the Lord. You wasn't going to be there in the daytime and run home at night. Y'all understand? Well, Uncle Sam wants you. He wants all of you. He wants your whole attention. Nah, you can't bring your girlfriend. You can't bring your boyfriend. You can't bring your animals. He just wants you. He wants to concentrate on getting you what you need to be.
Amen.
So it is with God. God's concerned about the offering. But he's equally concerned about the person that brings the offering.
Amen.
Thank you.
God, the scriptures say God loves a tearful giver. And the reason I'm talking about it is because people have made God into something God is not. You understand, saying just come like you are, bring what you have. God understands. It ain't even about money. God understands. As long as you come. No, you got to be reading a whole nother Bible to draw that conclusion. You would have to not be read this one at all to draw that conclusion about God.
All right. All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. The Bible says Cain and his offering, God had no respect. Now there are some theories as to why God didn't respect his offering and why he respected the offering of Abel. For if Cain tilled the ground and was a farmer, the offering that he brought would not have involved any blood. Y'all understand that? But in faith, Cain are able to understand that without the shedding of blood, there can be no remission of sin. So he understands what it is that God requires. Then why is it important that we bless God? Why is it important? It's not just some people feel, well, I'm being blessed anyway.
Yeah.
I don't pay no tithes. And I still got this. I keep my money. And I still got it. You got it right now.
All
right.
But if he promised to rebuke the devourer for your sake as a result of your bringing your prize to him, then one day if you're not paying up, the devourer is going to devour everything you have, not just what you have, but also you.
Amen.
That's the scripture now. Now, sometimes we give, but it's grudging. And I understand that because when I go to a church and they say we're going to receive the offering. And as soon as I see it on the program, in fact, before I leave home, I've already decided how much I intend to put in the offering. Now, an offering is not what somebody tells you to give.
That's right.
Amen.
That wouldn't be an offering.
Right.
An offering means you offer something.
Yeah.
You understand?
Amen.
And then when you go there and folk put the plate up and say, we're going to receive the offering, and they come back and tell them, no, y'all, we need $50 more.
Amen.
They can make you give,
girl.
They can, listen, I've written checks just to make them stop. You know, just sit down, just leave people alone.
Amen.
You're going to cancel out everything else that has happened, begging folk to do something that they don't want to do. You don't get no credit something that you don't want to give. He loves a cheerful giver. Now, there are some other folk who do give who have it misconstrued. Some folk give just because of the benefit that lies in giving to God. But God doesn't want us just to give because of the benefit. But God wants us to give because we love Him and we know that it's right to give. We understand that when we give, we're helping somebody who can't help themselves. Because the Bible says God has made promises to people, and we are the ones to carry out the promises that God has made. We are the ones. We say God feeds you if you're hungry. We're not talking about God's gonna literally come down and stick a spoon in your mouth. But God has people who have thought right, who have lived right, who have paid right, who are willing to share, who are willing to lend the helping hand. That's what being saved is all about.
All right, sir.
You can't do that. Can we all put a pin in the plate? Money for the church, this to help you. The church doing pretty good.
Amen.
But this is to help you.
Yeah.
God had no respect. Uh-huh. Now let me say this. Sometimes we do stuff to get the respect of other folks.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You understand people. Uh-huh. And if that's what makes you happy,
all right, now,
then keep on.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. But I think it's important to have the respect of God. I'd much rather have God happy with me than all the people in the world. Than have all the people in the world happy with me and have God displeased with me. Praise the Lord. Let me just get on. I got some more stuff to say. So he says, Cain's offering had no respect.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it could have been that he felt like he didn't owe God nothing.
My Lord.
Could have been that he only gave it because Abel was giving.
Yeah. Right.
Y'all ain't said that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It could have been he felt that God didn't do the work.
Wow.
Even though it was God that had to wake him up.
Yeah.
So he could do the work. Y'all ain't saying that. Y'all hear folks going, I'm not putting nothing there. I ain't finna make the preacher rich. The preacher gonna have what he gonna have whether you put something there or not. Especially this one. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Praise the Lord. You ain't got to worry about buying me a car. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You ain't got to worry about buying me no house. Y'all got to fix it. You ain't got to worry about whether or not I have a suit or what. You can't take credit. But God drives.
Amen.
You can't tell your heart. I'll tell you that.
Amen.
There are folks who see other folks stuffing envelopes, and I guess they say that ought to be enough.
All right.
$50. They don't need to be putting them. You think we crazy? You think we stuffing envelopes for the fun of it?
Right.
Amen. Bless
you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And by the way, this church has been doing real good.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
We have.
Amen.
Praise
Thank you.
The Lord.
Thank you.
I ain't got no complaints.
Glory, glory.
But I think I can help some more. You know? So the Bible says that when God had no respect for Cain and his offering, y'all still got that Bible. You can get that real quick. Verse 5 says that Cain was very wroth and his countenance fell.
Uh-huh.
That is to say, he got mad.
Yeah.
My mama used to say he got hell in him. Y'all understand? He got mad.
Yeah.
And poked his mouth out. He stopped smiling and started frowning.
Uh-huh.
And the Bible said God was so good still.
Yeah.
So God didn't leave him hanging.
Yeah. All right.
But came and told him, Cain, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
You didn't get it right.
My Lord.
But why are you mad?
Yeah.
See, that's how we are. We do wrong and get mad with God about the results. Y'all ain't saying. But if you know what the results are for something, y'all ain't saying.
right.
There's no need to get mad when it happens.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Amen.
If you know something gonna hurt you,
yeah.
If you know somebody gonna break your